I'm going to be discussing representation in games, specifically good representation of LGBT characters. And the game that I'm going to be talking about is Dragon Age Inquisition, which was recently developed by BioWare and published by EA. This game is primarily an action RPG where the player plays as the Inquisitor to defeat the evil force that's trying to tear the world apart. The game gives the player a lot of choice in how they play the game and features a heavy emphasis on dialogue interactions and with NPCs and choices that the player makes. An extension of this is the ability to romance different characters, and this is obviously a lot of good representation of LGBT characters. Out of these characters, 8 of them are available to romance, 2 of them are gay, 2 are bisexual, and 4 are straight, and there's also a character there who is transgender, who is a minor character, who plays a mercenary for the Inquisition. Does this well because the inclusion of these characters is a step up from many other games which don't feature LGBT characters and provides us with a balanced representation of sexual orientations. Furthermore, the characters are not stereotypes of their sexualities and have deep backgrounds in many other aspects of their personalities besides the sexual orientation. The game also contains dialogue and missions which directly address issues that LGBT people may face, such as conflict with family, persecution and harassment. And that concludes my part.
Okay. So I'll be talking about the stereotypes and representation in the game of Grand Theft Auto V, which was designed by the company Rockstar to be as close as a depiction of modern day America and real life as possible. So I thought it would be worthwhile looking at this game and see what its depiction is used for in the game and how it impacts the game. To be more exact, the part of America the game is depicting is from the setting of Los Santos is Los Angeles, which can be clear from its name to the landmarks in the game that it replicates, and uses the setting then to represent more darker parts of American culture, such as black criminal gangs, which were used to create this dark tone for the game. So these gang members are sometimes used in the game as enemies and are represented with the stereotypes of black gangs in America at the time, such as them having constantly saying the N-word to each other in dialogue, having them sell weed and commit a car theft. Well, it could be seen as very stereotypical. It does seem to fit the setting of the game and the intention of the game. There's other elements of American culture the game uses, such as rednecks and prostitutes, but considering the criminal nature of the game and the setting of the game, seems to fit the game's tone, which I'm going to go on to fill now.
For my part of the presentation, I will be looking at The Witcher 3, which was produced by CD Projekt Red. For CG Projekt Red, they created quite a few fantastical environments, but they had relatable cultures that are believable within the Witcher 3 universe. This is by amalgamating multiple different cultures from our real world together, so that it helps to mirror our own, especially whenever they're sort of compared to each other. The first, Skellige, Skellige is closely related to historical Scandinavia. The culture itself is inspired by tradition and architectural by Vikings and has a healthy Celtic influence, most notably which is the accent of the area, which is actually from Northern Ireland itself. The drizzly cold weather, cold climates, harsh mountain landscapes and such help to replicate the Nordic fjords that you'd find out in the real world. And it helps to mirror that, what do I find in also the representation of people who live there. It's historically quite a egalitarian place, Scandinavian countries such as Denmark and Sweden. Through this, it's normally heavily pagan, and strong female characters that are most normally not in any way weak and are quite often just as well prepared as their male counterparts. The next place, Toussaint, by itself, quite different has a lot of influences, and come primarily from Italy and France during the Renaissance period. While it is the furthest from what we've found being realistic, it's an exaggerated hybrid of the two cultures with a big focus on the common denominator of wine. Developed at sort of providing a picturesque landscape with bright, vibrant colours and beautiful weather compared to the sort of drizzly weather of Skalga. It sort of emphasises the sort of luxurious lifestyle environment that will be associated with those two cultures. Along with it, it's that more delicate nature of the society comes with its representation of women, which play a more damsel role, because there's, just like back then with the Renaissance period, a lot of emphasis on chivalry, and women fall into that role to play along with it. Any questions? That's my part.